Here it is. This is the ultimate alto instrument that I've been telling you about. I know you're thinking, explain yourself. That is nonsense. No, it really is an alto instrument, at least in my opinion. So before I start rambling and explaining myself, let's just have a listen. It's very nice. I've been looking for quite a while. Not quite like a French horn, but blends like a French horn. But yet unique, dark, but not quite the same. Not as heavy. Very nice. So, one day I was looking on eBay and I saw this. And I thought, okay, there's a trombone mouthpiece hanging out. That might be alto shank, so we're good. And this looked to be about 468 to my eyeballs. I thought, well, that's the kind of instrument I've been looking for a very, very, very long time. I can't believe I'm actually going to be able to get it for that cheap. And so I scratched one off the bucket list, hit by it now, and got the instrument. After a little bit of research, I figured out what it was actually supposed to be called. This is not a cornone. So if anyone has an example of a cornone, please let someone know, because apparently there's still yet to be an example of those found, despite the alleged significance of the instrument. And this is not alto shank, much to my annoyance. And this is not 468, much to my delight. So, now, you might look at this and think, it kind of looks like a British baritone horn with rotor valves. What's so special about that? And if you're from Europe, you might even think, that's a tenor horn, you're an idiot. Hold on. Because you're almost right. Size-wise, this is very similar to a British baritone horn at this point. To about here on in, forget about it. And yes, this would have been probably marketed as a tenor horn, and that is very important to its provenance. And I will explain that. But first, let's pose a question. If you are ordering a tenor horn and you get this, how thrilled are you? Because I'm going to show you a tenor horn next to this, and I think you're going to agree with me, you would not be thrilled at all. So a tale of two tenor horns, Althorn in B and Bass Flugelhorn. Yeah. Uh-oh. Oops. Got a little bit of clashing going on there. Yeah. If you want this, and you get this, you are probably not very thrilled. And there's another reason you're probably not very thrilled. This mouthpiece does not belong to this instrument. This is an alto trombone mouthpiece, actually. and it plays like absolute trash on here. Yeah, even this thing with its very shallow cup and 22.5 millimeter cup diameter, very hard to play high, goes flat up north. You have no idea how bad I was lipping that in. Yeah, bit of a problem. And I think that's exactly what happened. Because when I got this horn, the corks were pristine. This bridge point right here was broke. I've just kind of glued it into place because I kind of want to keep this fake patina that's been applied on here. And the fake patina was applied after this was broken. I know because you can see the spot where they missed. This cork was pristine, but the spring was broken, so I had to replace that. And of course, so I fixed the thing up, started playing it, and all the corks started to crack and fall apart. The spring completely destroyed this cork. So I was like, well, hold on. I have pristine corks that are now falling apart as if they were original, because they probably were. And a horn that has obviously seen some neglect. In fact, you know what this is? This is where this thing got shot with a 6mm pellet. And there's no markings on this horn. So this was probably some West German military band's attempt to acquire some tenor horns. And they got this and probably got it with a mouthpiece that, you know, looked about this big and thought, no. Tried logically to get something that would hopefully play in tune. No. And being dissatisfied, chucked the thing in the closet where it remained ever since. And in fact, if you look at most of the dents on this horn, look like where bells have clacked into the tubing, because they're all flat, except for this here. So yeah, I think they ordered up some tenor horns from Meister Dotzauer. And of course, since he was operating in, I think, GDR or Czechoslovakia at the time. I don't know which of the two, but one of those two satellite states. Couldn't put a brand label on this because then they couldn't import it. You can't be in West Germany playing filthy communist instruments. So, very unfortunate. Lucky for me, because now I've got a horn with, oh my goodness, the compression on this thing. Let's see if I can find it. Yeah. Pop. Never have I had a horn with such good that's the third valve slide. Such good compression. The machining on these valves. The finest ever. I almost feel bad for having to do these hack job repairs on this thing. I mean, we've got, you know, Buna In O-ring bumpers and the Buna In, whatever you call it, cork replacement. And this is a hack job spring on here. I feel bad for having to do this. This horn deserves so much better. I do kind of like this fake patina. So let's talk about the quest to get a mouthpiece for this thing. Obviously, I tried playing it with this because I thought, well, shoot, maybe I'm wrong. This is a tenor instrument. Heck no. Plays like trash with that. So I tried my Con Alto mouthpiece, and, you know, it sounded pretty good. Felt a little bit small, but it worked. And I looked at, you know, photos on the internet to try and figure out what kind of mouthpiece this would have, and I found some. I found more Althorn NB, and they all have very small mouthpieces, about no bigger than 20 millimeter cup diameter, probably 19 or 19.5. I tried with my Baroque trumpet mouthpiece, and the slotting was really good. intonation was good. Of course, sound was way off because wrong cup entirely. But so I had a plan. I knew what could make this play in tune. So I needed something that would fit this shank though. So one of the first attempts, because I got the E flat alto horn, the big one, and so I was like, well, these both have the same receiver, so I'll try this. This does not work right. This is way too deep for this horn. It plays tenor with this mouthpiece. Sounds good, but way too deep. Even with this 19.5 millimeter cup diameter, still goes flat up top. Now, you could call up Zig Stardust and get the baritone to French horn adapter, and you could try that. So the Schilke 32, it does play. It works all right. So thin. And with the 31B, it's even worse. You know, gone is that really haunting sound that I was getting with the alto mouthpiece. Now, I contacted the guy. He hasn't sent his mouthpiece yet. He's still working on it because he's in college. Nobody else I contacted was actually willing to make a mouthpiece for this. They either didn't reply or they gave me replies that were ridiculous. Finally, after having gotten the PA-1B, I contacted Joseph Clear. And I was like, look, I like the PA-1B. It works great on the other instrument, but I've got this thing and it's way too deep. What can you do for me? Can you help? And after a long conversation, came up with this idea. This is the theoretical PA-1E, they even marked it PA-1E, 24 millimeter cup depth, 4.2 millimeter throat, so they even marked that on here, and then the 10.5 millimeter shank. And there it is. There's my 9-foot B-flat alto. So good. This horn, the way it's designed, very well. It does make some very strange ergonomic decisions for the sake of looking better. For instance, this doesn't sit on your lap very well because you've moved the lead pipe down and in, so the hand position is also not that great, but it makes it look better. And if you've done enough instrument research, you will know looks are important. So again, I think this instrument was intended to be like a cavalry marching French horn alternative. I do not know that for a fact. It is kind of strange that something like that would be made in like the 1960s or 70s. And indeed, there is something kind of like this still made today. The Dotzauer Tenorhorn 3095 is just like this, except it has 500 bore, which will play considerably different. However, it does still have a very small mouthpiece. The Dotzauer stock mouthpiece for this looks kind of like a Bach alto horn mouthpiece, but with a round cup, and you know, of course, the shank is a different size. But of course, I didn't want, you know, round cup on this. I didn't think it would sound very good. But yeah, I'm so happy with this. This is awesome. You know what? I don't have anything more to say about it. Just leave it at that.